diesel. What a beautiful day. What a beautiful day. Oh, it's a beautiful day. Look at that blue sky. Sun coming up over there. Oh, trucks everywhere. Tell you what, that's a beautiful day. Come on, Diesel. Leave all the garbage alone. I know it's just a truck stop, but you gotta ignore the garbage. Aim, buddy, aim. It's such a problem with aiming, especially in the morning. Oh, why don't you just get it all out at once? I don't understand. You gotta do a little bit here, a little bit there, a little squirt over there, squirt over here. I understand your whole marking attitude, but you have to understand my rushing attitude. We need to deliver. So we are in, what did I say we were in yesterday? I think I said we were in Lexington. We're actually in Winchester. Look, there's their little water tower thing over there. We're here at the back of the parking spaces here. And somebody again. I hate having to point this out all the time, but guys, you really gotta stop dumping your garbage at the truck stops. I have a feeling that it's gonna start affecting all of us, and we're all gonna have to live with some kind of fee or something. Like, soon they're gonna charge us to park anywhere like they do in Europe. And then if we get caught, well, if you do get caught littering, it's a $500 fine. There was a sign just over there somewhere. I saw it. That's a $500 fine. Pretty soon that's why no one wants truckers anywhere, you know that? That's why nobody wants us to park anywhere overnight, because they're scared you're gonna do this. Sad. Saddens me. You know, people who do this, maybe should, park their rig and go play on the play structure with people their maturity. We call them children. But children are innocent. They're learning. They do this kind of stuff, and we teach them not to, and then they go fix it. Adults, we're supposed to know that this is wrong. But what do you think about that, Diesel? I'm very disappointed in humanity, man. Very disappointed. Are we expecting too much of humanity? Expecting them not to do stuff like that? Look at that face. He's like, man, you expect way too much from people. People are lazy, man. You just gotta accept that, man. Stop talking about it, they're just lazy. I guess so. I guess that's the fact. Pointing out the fact that everyone's littering isn't gonna fix the problem. But maybe they're watching my video right now and they're looking at me on the screen going, oops, I did that. They're probably laughing. People are just weird. Weird. Well, Mandy says I have 358 kilometers to go. That's about 3.5 hours of good, solid, uninterrupted driving. I have a feeling that it won't be uninterrupted. But we should get going anyway.
I believe we're on Highway 15 in Kentucky, headed towards the western corner of Virginia. Apparently, this is the only way or the fastest way of getting there, so here we go. It's a little bit of a scenic route, so I'm not complaining. It's just going to take me a little longer than I thought to actually get to my destination, but that's okay, we'll still be on time. Look at this, eh? Look at all those vines growing up and down there. Ooh. Very nice. Very nice, Kentucky. Isn't this such a beautiful part of the world? Look at this on the left here again, that whole cliff, that whole rock is just covered in vines. Right here, on the left. It's all vines. Wow. What do you guys think of this? Wouldn't it be cool to live around an area like this? Like, look at these telephone poles on the right. They're all covered in vines. I don't even know if that's safe, but it looks awesome. It looks awesome. There's a weeping willow tree. I think those trees are funny. On the left again, that whole rock face is covered in those vines. It's incredible. Wow. And then those vines grow all the way up the trees. So much green. It's incredible. Look at this, like a jungle. Second there, yellow Jeep. Okay. Alright. Alright, okay. Okay, Mila. Alright. Whatever. So yeah, there are some benefits to taking the scenic route. I usually don't take the scenic route unless if it's a shortcut. And this just happens to be a shortcut. So, here we are. Do any of you live down here anywhere? Am I passing any of your houses by any chance? Well, actually, don't answer that. Don't tell people where you live. Don't do that. Tell me if you live in the area, though. We're on Highway 15 in Kentucky. I like this area. It's more of them. Man, those vines are everywhere. Wow. You know what you could do? You could take those vines, plant them around your house, and they'd grow up and over your house, and it'd look like you just live in a big shrub. Natural camouflage. They'll never find you. That's true living in the bush. I'd do that to my house, that'd be awesome. Except in wintertime, that all the vines would die in Manitoba. Then it just looks ugly, because you got all these stringies. Weeds almost all over your house. Anyways, that's a little bit of the scenery that's entering my eyes this morning. Oh, we made it. Thank goodness we made it, and thank goodness for air conditioning. Don't blow on my camera right now, though. Oh, we made it. What a crazy, twisty, windy, hilly road to get here. Virginia, you know I love you, but you got some crazy hills out here. And usually I would like that, but when I'm 80,000 pounds, it sort of slows me down a bit. Oh well, it was okay. Gained some experience that way, right? Running with heavyweight through the hills. Very slow, up and down. Anyways, we made it. The weasel's back there being a weasel. How you doing, weasel? Being a weasel? That's a good weasel. Good boy. I saw tail wag. Good boy. Good boy. Glad you're so happy. Anyways, guys, so we're gonna get unloaded here. And then we're going to take off to Covington, Virginia, where we're picking up a load going to Winnipeg. We're going to drop that load in Winnipeg on Sunday, and then we've already got another load waiting for us there. That load is taking us to Ontario, Quebec, and Newfoundland. I had to build the suspense there a little bit. Plus, I've got a scratch in my throat. I'm fighting coughing. Need some water. So yes, we're going back home, and then we're going across Eastern Canada right to the island, Newfoundland. That means another ferry ride. All right, so we got unloaded. Now we got to head 355 kilometers, 3.5, 4 hours to get reloaded. They're open 24 hours, thank goodness, because we're gonna be there later this evening. And then we're gonna try to get as close to home as we can tonight yet, so let's go. Wow. First impression after getting that much weight out of my trailer and now pulling an empty trailer. Wow, I feel light as a feather. I feel like just flying through here. Yes, Mandy, I know. We're almost at the freeway, and then we're gonna take I-64 north up to Covington, somewhere around there, I think. Yes, Mandy, I know. There's a narrow bridge coming. There's a narrow this coming. There's a narrow that coming. Everything's narrow here. I get it. Those 3 hours this morning to be stretched out. Like I was saying, those Virginia roads, they slowed me down quite a bit there with that heavy load. Or maybe it was the heavy load that slowed me down and not the roads. I don't know. Either way, I was slow this morning with all that weight. So now that I'm empty, going as quick as I legally can to go pick up this new load. And then I gotta drive a few hours after we pick it up yet. The sun's already starting to go down. Well, here we are. I don't know exactly where. At the end of the road for today. A good 10.5 hours of driving again. Guys, thanks for joining us today. I'm about to walk the weasel here. My truck is a mess and chaos and wires everywhere because I'm putting my footage from all my cameras onto one computer right now, and I'm trying to do it all at once, so just cables, cameras everywhere. But that way gets done the fastest because I'm tired. It's like 2 a.m. and I want to go to bed, and I still have to shower yet and walk the weasel. So we're going to edit it up tomorrow sometime on our break, halfway through the day. Other than that,
Diesel, are you ready to go outside, man? Are you ready, man? You've been waiting so patiently. You're such a good boy. I'm a very good boy, man. Don't forget the very. A very good boy. And look at that face.
I still got to Google it. Someone out there Google, why don't dogs like cameras? See you tomorrow, 4 a.m. Central Time, guys. Go down below to the description. You can find videos from what I was doing all the way up to a year ago. Also, don't forget to hit the thumbs up button if you did like the video. It reminds me that you like the video. Simple as that. Reminds me that maybe I should make another video.